In this segment, we'll answer the question that many times you might have more equations than unknowns, or more unknowns than equations. So in that case, does it mean that we have inconsistent system of equations? Because most times people think that whenever you are given simultaneous linear equations, you have n number of equations, n number of unknowns. But that's not necessarily the case. You could have more unknowns than equations, or more equations than unknowns. So let's answer this particular question, that if we have more equations than unknowns, does it always mean that we have inconsistent system of equations? The categorical answer is no. Let's take some examples and see what happens. So we'll take three examples. So let's take this example right here. So if somebody gives us a set of equations like this, 25, 5, 1, 64, 8, 1, 144, 12, 1, 89, 13, 2, and x1, x2, x3 is equal to 106.8, 177.2, 279.2, and 284.0. So here you're clearly seeing that you got four equations and three unknowns, because you got four rows right here, four rows right here. And people might say, hey, I cannot solve this set of equations. So we don't know. So what we have to see is that whether the question of whether a particular system of equations is consistent or inconsistent has to be looked at, because it's all based on the rank of the coefficient matrix and the rank of the augmented matrix. In this case, so if we write this symbolically, that hey, this is AX equal to C, what we're going to see is that the rank of A, and this again you'll have to find out, the rank of A is 3. And you'll also find out that the rank of the augmented matrix, which will be just adding this column to the A matrix here, you're going to find out, hey, that is also 3. And since you're finding out that the rank of the coefficient matrix is same as the rank of the augmented matrix, what does that mean? That means that we have a consistent system of equations. Not only that, since the rank of A is equal to number of unknowns, because the rank of A is 3 and the number of unknowns is also 3, x1, x2, x3. So what that also means is that it has a unique solution. So not only are we able to show that somebody gives us four equations, three unknowns, that we have a consistent system of equations for this particular case, that we can have either infinite solutions or unique solution, but then by comparing the rank of the coefficient matrix with the number of unknowns, which is the same number, we're also able to show that this particular system of equations, four equations and three unknowns, has a unique solution. So let's look at another example. Let's look at another example. Somebody gives me a set of equations like this one. 25, 5, 1, 64, 8, 1, 144, 12, 1, 89, 13, 2, x1, x2, x3 is equal to 106.8, 177.2, 279.2, and 280.0. So somebody is now giving you, again, four equations and three unknowns. So we want to determine whether this particular system of equations is consistent or inconsistent. So in this case, what you'll find out that when you run this process, you'll find out the rank of A will turn out to be three. The rank of A will turn out to be 3. So this coefficient matrix, so let me write this as A times X is equal to C. So you got A as the coefficient matrix, X as the unknown vector, C as the right-hand side vector. You'll find the rank of this coefficient matrix, it turns out to be 3. And the rank of the augmented matrix, which is basically this column being added to the A matrix, so making it four rows and four columns, that turns out to be 4. So what we are finding out is that rank of A is less than the rank of the augmented matrix, because this is 3 and this is 4. So what does this mean? That means that we have an inconsistent system of equations. because the rank of the quotient matrix is strictly less than the rank of the augmented matrix. So which means that when we say it's inconsistent, that means that there no solution exists for this set of equations. And we'll look at yet another example to see that, hey, what does it mean when we have more equations than unknowns? Let's look at another example. C, this is the third example we're taking. And somebody gives us this set of questions, 25, 5, 1, 64, 8, 1, 50, 10, 2, 89, 13, 2, x1, x2, x3 is equal to 106.8, 177.2, 213.6, and 280.0. So somebody's giving us four equations and three unknowns and is asking us, hey, can you figure out whether this particular system of equations is consistent or inconsistent? So when you will look at this particular matrix, you'll find out that the rank of, so let me just write it symbolically, AX equal to C here. So A is my quotient matrix, X is my unknown vector, C is my solution vector. We find out that, hey, rank of A turns out to be 2. And of course, you'll have to find it out that why that is so. You'll find out the rank of this quotient matrix, which is 4 rows and 3 columns, turns out to be 2. The rank of the augmented matrix, which is taking this right-hand side right here, putting that as the fourth column here, so we get a 4x4 matrix, and that rank also turns out to be 2. So the rank of the quotient matrix is same as the rank of the augmented matrix. That means that we have a consistent system of equations. So that means either we have unique solution or we have infinite number of solutions. But what we are finding out is that rank of A, and if we compare them with the number of unknowns, what do we see? The rank of A is 2 and the number of unknowns is 3. So rank of A is less than the number of unknowns, which means that we, although it's a consistent system of equations, will have infinite solutions. So although we were asked to only figure out whether a particular system of equations is consistent or not, but we're going to step further to say, hey, if the system of equations turns out to be consistent, hey, do we have a unique solution or do we have infinite solutions? In this example, the rank of A is same as the rank of the augmented matrix, making proving that, hey, it's a consistent system of equations, but the rank of the quotient matrix is less than the number of unknowns, and that tells us that, hey, we will have infinite number of solutions. And that's the end of this segment.